Sharon. And as you saw, I came tonight with my date, the senator. I was proud to walk in with her, and I'm also proud to be the only male here tonight. All right? That makes me either too comfortable or brave. I'm not sure yet.
We'll say brave.
But I'm happy to be here and support this organization and any group that comes together in a structured format to be heard on the issues that are important to them, and no one can be more important than the great women in this country. Political clubs and organizations are so important, and over the years, they've dwindled in numbers and support. So it's refreshing for me to see a group of women coming together, revitalizing a entity which existed prior, to be the focus and the voice of our women and their concerns. And we know there are many of them. My biggest gripe and argument, and I present at every occasion that I can, is the inequality in pay. Women do the same job as men, sometimes even better than men, but get less in the form of equity and pay for that position, including my staff, which is Natalia Fernandez.
Hey, Natalia.
She grinned on that one for obvious reasons. But in my office, I don't have a male paid staff, so there's no competition for Natalia. But there are so many issues when it comes to the women and the voice that needs to be heard, especially in this borough. We have some great national organizations. We have some wonderful state organizations. But I don't know of a woman's organization that is a voice for the needs of the women in this borough. And I'm encouraged not only to be here with you tonight, but support you and know that you have someone that you can lean on. I'll continue to be here in every which way possible, from staff to moral support, some financial support if need be, and I think tonight we sponsor the refreshments, right? This is all part of embracing one another and realizing the importance that collectively we have a lot in common. And you'd be surprised that your issues are my issues and vice versa. And that is for bringing back a gender that represents not only women, but all Bronxites, regardless of race, regardless of ethnicity, regardless of age. We have issues here that stem from unemployment, quality of life issues, children issues that all of you can certainly understand, how our children don't have that future that we have available to us, that their future for the first time, the next generation, doesn't seem to be able to fare better than the past generation. Mm-hmm. That's our failure. Yes. That's not our children's failure. Mm-hmm. And organizations like this will go a long way in bringing those issues to the attention of our electeds, whether it be local, state, or federal. That's a responsibility that we all bear. And seeing so many of you here tonight, taking the time, finding the time, making the time, knowing that you have homes to go to and families and children that are waiting for you, means a lot. So I'm grateful to all of you for being here. Know that you have a true friend and supporter. Continue doing some great work. And remember that the world is what you make of it. And if silence is not the answer. God bless you all. Continue to make the world a better place.